Hi, my name is David and welcome back to another video on specialty printing on our channel. You might have been seeing a few videos from our channel and they've all about white toner and white toner transfer printing. Today, I want to introduce you to a new kind of specialty toner that we've been carrying for quite a long time. We just never made a video about it. And this is our neon toner. So what is neon toner? Neon toner is a toner in a special neon color, so a fluorescent color that actually has two fantastic features. First, it can be used as a spot color, enabling you to print cool neon designs. And second, it is fluorescent under black light, and I will show this in the course of the video, how you can use this effect to create really cool specialty printing items. Our neon toners are available for a range of printers. Of course, for our little ghost printer, which is based on the Canon LBP 622, 623 series, but there are also other Canon printers available which can use our neon toners. And our neon toners are available on the HP Color LaserJet M452DW, which is another A4 printer, and on what we call the big ghost printer, the HP Color LaserJet CP5225 series. They come in three colors, and all three colors are kind of like spot colors. So we have a neon cyan, neon yellow, and neon magenta cartridge. They come in the packaging that you're used to. All the details are here on the side, which printer they're compatible with, and so on. So what can you do with neon toner? With neon toner, you can make your designs on the screen just as you would using the colors cyan, yellow, and magenta. And of course black or white, whatever you need. And then print it on standard copy paper or also use it in transfer to different items, like for example these mugs. And you can create a fantastic neon effect. I'll just show this to you before I do a little printing. So as you can see in these examples, the colors are not exactly printed the way they look on the screen. So the yellow is actually more like a greenish, kind of fluorescent neon color. The magenta is strongly neon colored, and also the blue is kind of off. It's not like a traditional cyan, it's more like a neon cyan. And under black light, these three colors will give a nice fluorescent effect, which you're gonna see later in the video. So how is the printing process done? First, we head over to the printer and we're gonna check which cartridges are inside the printer. You can see that I have already inserted the yellow toner in neon, the neon magenta toner and the neon cyan toner, and in this case I'm using my ghost white toner. If you take a look at the bottom of the toner, you will recognize that it has the neon toner inside. I'll just show you a quick difference by comparing it to a regular toner cartridge. So this is a neon magenta, you can see it here, and I'll just compare it to the regular magenta. So you can definitely see the difference. The neon is much brighter, it's already, you know, when it's inside the toner, not through the yet, a different color. Same on the yellow, it kind of looks more greenish already. The fluorescent effect is kind of visible. So I'll pop back the cartridge tray, close the printer. As usual, our little ghost printer does calibrate itself, so you can swap the toner cartridges as often as you need to between the regular toners, between the neon toners and the sublime toners, which can be used in transfer. So on what kind of papers can you print? You can literally print on any paper that this printer can handle. I'd like to show you one difference in this video. So most standard office papers, even if they are more heavyweight, use artificial brightness, which make the paper kind of like really bright. And this is going to make the neon effect, especially under black light, less visible. I'm going to print on a paper that does not use artificial brightness. You can definitely see a difference between these two papers. So I'm going to run two prints, the first one on the regular copy paper and the second one on my paper without artificial brighteners, so that we can see the difference. I'm going to load the paper in the bottom tray of my printer. For the print settings, there's not much you have to keep in mind when printing with neon toners. I would recommend that you only use strong colors, so 100% cyan, 100% magenta, 100% yellow, to get the most effect, the strongest effect in the print. And I'm going to run that print here first on the regular copy paper, and then immediately the same design on my special paper without artificial brightness. You can see the top one is the not brightened paper, this is the regular copy paper, and you can see quite a bit of a difference. If I hold them next to each other, you can see it a little bit. So the colors stick out a little more on this paper, although this here is brighter, but you will see the full effect on the black light. So I quickly just cut out my design. I usually like to print without any borders, so I'm just aligning my ruler here and just quickly cutting out this invitation. Now I've got my two designs cut out nicely next to each other, and I like to show you the effect under black light. All right, now I'm going to show you the two samples again. Remember, the sample on the right side is the paper without artificial whiteners, and you will see the effect coming up. There you go. So this is the one on paper without any artificial brighteners, and this is the one on regular copy paper. So you can see that the paper has so much brightener in there that you actually don't see the print in the middle, because it changes the color so much. So you barely can recognize it. So it's really recommended to print on paper without artificial whitener, but then the effect is great. So what you can see is that your blues come out really nicely. You get a very fantastic green neon effect from the yellow. You get a super cool orangey effect from the magenta. And this is really cool. I like it how the colors change, and how you can really also apply this to mugs, like you can see here. Or for example, we've made like a menu card here. And the effect is tremendous, especially under black light. But if you put the light back on, you will still get fantastic, nice neon colors and a really, really cool effect. So this can be used in any kind of stationary printing, printing of customized, personalized glassware or dishware for nightclubs, bars, pubs, or special parties. So you can really add a fantastic individual touch to your stationery, to your printing game, with our fluorescent neon toners. So this is how you can use fluorescent neon toner on cards, on paper. I still got my regular paper sample here. As you see, in regular light, it doesn't make such big of a difference. So if you just want to print some fantastic neon invitations for like a birthday party, or some nice neon greeting cards for your friends, family, events, or whatever, I think regular paper is pretty cool. But as soon as you want to use it under black light and achieve that special effect, some paper without artificial whiteners is highly recommended. If you like neon printing, you're very welcome to check out our webshop. We'll put the description, the links for the neon toners, so that you can order neon toner for your printer. Please leave us your comments with ideas what else you could do with neon toner, what you can achieve. If you like these kinds of videos, I would love you to leave us a thumbs up below. Make sure that you follow the channel so we can update you on new products and fantastic ideas for specialty printing. Make sure that you activate the bell so you'll get notified. In the meantime, I say thanks for watching and see you next time.